Hey guys, I'm going to show you how to apply nail powders without using gel polish. The powders I'm using in this video are really inexpensive and I'll link them down below.
Start off by applying your favorite base coat onto your bare nail.
Since we're not using gel polish, it's really important to make sure that every single layer of nail polish applied is completely dried before proceeding to the next step. In addition, it's important to cap the free edge to ensure that the nails last as long as possible. For my base color, I used a pink nail polish to achieve a rose gold effect. But traditionally, a black color is used to achieve that mirror chrome finish. Tap the free edge and let the nail polish dry completely, or else when the powder is buffed on top, the nail polish underneath will move. Powder is really messy. I'm going to apply a peel-off tape around the nail to make cleanup easier. Now I'm going to apply a layer of my favorite quick dry top coat, Sesh Feet, and let that dry for 3 minutes. I find the chrome powder adheres to top coat nicely, but the mermaid and holographic powders don't, so I'll be sharing another method later on. Here is a silver chrome powder. I'm going to use an eyeshadow sponge tip applicator to apply the powder, but you could use your fingers or a wedge sponge. Gently press the powder onto the nail to test if the top coat is neither too wet nor too dry. If the top coat is too wet, the nail polish will move and smudge underneath, and if the top coat is too dry, then the chrome powder won't adhere at all. As you can see, I'm just going in back and forth motions and going back in for more powder when needed. I find adding a second layer of the chrome powder gives an extra shiny finish, and you want to keep on buffing the powder onto the nail to smooth out as many of the particles as you can. You can flip over the sponge to kind of smooth out those straggler pieces, or even use a clean finger. Lastly, I'm going with my finger to flatten out any remaining particles. Then I'm going to remove the peel-off tape. Now here is a crucial step. Applying a regular top coat will mar the mirror chrome finish. To solve this problem, I've seen other people use water-based top coats or the Unt peel-off base coat, which also happens to be water-based. But all of these options you see on the screen are made from indie brands, meaning they aren't readily available and you can only buy them online. In addition, these are all definitely up there in price, especially considering that these are all water-based, meaning that they will eventually degrade in the shower, when you wash your hands, or do the dishes. So in general, they don't last nearly as long as regular nail polish does. Now, I discovered that clear Elmer's glue does the job just fine. In fact, my theory is that clear Elmer's glue and the Unt peel-off base coat are pretty similar, considering that they both have polyvinyl alcohol in their ingredients list.
I was curious to see if any other types of glue would work, so I tested nail foil glue, which I found worked, although there is still a bit of some pixelation. Next, I tested nail glue, which did not work. White Elmer's glue also didn't work. It left the nail really cloudy. Lastly, I tested Mod Podge, which is also water-based. It didn't completely ruin the mirror finish, but I wouldn't use it. So based on my experiments, I found that nail foil glue is a viable option, although I would just stick with clear Elmer's glue as it's available everywhere and super cheap.
And to apply it, all you need to do is squirt a bead onto a clean brush and apply a thin layer onto the nail and let it dry for about 4 to 5 minutes. Since glue does peel off the skin pretty easy, you don't want to cap the free edge with the glue or else the nails won't last as long. As you can see, the glue didn't ruin the chrome finish. Finally, to seal everything in, you want to go in with a generous layer of regular top coat. Again, I'm using Sesh Feet, and really make sure to cap the free edge.
And here is the finished product. I will note, whether you use clear Elmer's glue or a water-based top coat, these nails will last at most a week, because as I mentioned before, since they're all water-based, they are going to eventually degrade when you wash your hands and take a shower and things like that.
Here is a photo from September, taken 2 days after application. I did use nail foil glue instead of clear Elmer's glue. You can see how nail foil glue doesn't give you quite as a nice finish as Elmer's glue. But as you can see, there's definitely some wear on the tips of the nail.
Here is a photo from March when I also used nail foil glue. The wear on the tips of the nail are definitely noticeable.
Now let's get on to the holographic powder. I'm going to first start off with a black nail polish. You can use whatever color you would like since the powders are semi-opaque. Same thing from before, you want to make sure to cap the free edge and ensure every single layer of nail polish is completely dry. And here is the holographic powder. Now this one was the most expensive out of the three, and by expensive, I think it was only like $5 or $6, which is a lot cheaper. I've seen other places sell it for $40, although granted you do get more product in those, but you still do get a lot in this one. I found that the holo powder didn't adhere to top coat as well. I had to use a lot more pressure, and even then there would be patches with no powder. So instead, I used a tacky base coat. This is Zoya Anchor, which as you can see, it says adheres nail color. You don't have to use the same base coat I'm using. You just want to use one that dries a little tacky and sticky. There are some other options, CND Stickey, American Classics Yellow Stopper, ORLY Bonder, and SC First Base. I'm pretty sure there's a lot more. Those are just the ones I found. These also do come in professional sizes, which I do recommend buying if you're really into nail art because it will save you a lot of money. So you want to apply the sticky base coat over the completely dried base color, and you want to let the base coat dry at minimum 5 minutes. Once again, I'm applying peel off tape around my nail to make cleanup easier. Once the base coat has dried, go ahead and press the powder onto the nail. I did use my fingers for this one to show you that if you don't have any sponges, you could still do this with just your finger. Although if you have long nails, it may get a little messy dipping your finger into the jar. Definitely use a mixture of just your sponge and your finger and just kind of going back and forth in between them. I do use the sponge to apply the powder, and then I go with my finger to really smooth it out. Going in with a second layer and increases the reflective finish. And since we're using a base coat, you definitely want to go in with very light pressure with both the finger and the sponge so that the nail polish underneath doesn't move and smudge. I did find with the top coat that you could really go in and the top coat wouldn't smudge. I'm just going to remove the peel off tape. Apply a layer of clear Elmer's glue. Let the glue dry for 5 minutes before applying a layer of regular top coat, once again using sesh feet. And here is the finished product. As you can see, it's a super fiery hollow. It's so beautiful. So what I said earlier holds true to the hollow powder as well. You will see wear on the tips of the nail and see the black peeking through. So to kind of disguise that, you can use a silver holographic base instead of a black. That way the wear on the tips of the nails aren't quite as noticeable. The comparison between the hollow buffed on top of black and the hollow buffed on top of hollow. The hollow buffed on top of the hollow is a bit lighter than the hollow buffed on top of the black. And here's what they both look like with indirect lighting. As you can see, you don't get that rainbow fiery effect. Lastly, I'm going to show you how to do the unicorn nails. So I'm using actually three different nail polishes for my base color. So I'm going to start off with the pink. Then I'm going to apply a stripe of purple down the middle, but not completely cover the pink we applied before. Lastly, I'm going to apply the blue right down the center, making sure not to cover the purple. And then I'm going to go in with a top coat to just kind of blend the colors together. People do this technique with gel, and you can blend the gel because it doesn't dry unless you use a lamp. I found even without blending the colors completely to a seamless ombre, it still comes out to be really pretty when you buff the powder on top. Same with the holographic powder, I found that the unicorn slash mermaid powder sticks best onto a sticky base coat, so I'm just going to apply a layer of that and let it dry for 5 minutes. Last two demos, I used peel-off tape, but for this one, I'm going to use a peel-off face mask. And you can easily just sub out the two. You can use liquid latex, or you could even not use anything and just wash it off in the sink. I'm just going to apply that with a clean brush around the nail, and it takes about the same time to dry as the base coat does. And this is what the mermaid slash unicorn powder looks like. It has these really beautiful different color shifts to it. And to apply this one, I'm going to use a makeup sponge. And I literally just cut up an old beauty blender I had. And once again, you can use your fingers and eyeshadow sponge applicator. Just trying to show you the variety of different application tools you can use. So I'm just gently patting the product onto the nail, and once I've got the product evenly spread, I am going to go ahead and just rub it in. Once again, rub it gently. Now I did try using one of these silicone tools I've seen a lot of nail techs use. I personally didn't really like using it that much just because it's so dense and hard that I did find it kind of smudged the nail polish underneath. So for gel nail polish, the silicone applicator works well, but for regular polish, I would just stick to using either your finger or a sponge. And once again, I'm just really kind of smoothing out the powder with my finger. The fingers are the real MVP of this. When you're done smoothing out the powder, peel off the peel-off face mask. And what's nice about using a peel-off face mask is that it does moisturize the skin around your nails for a bit. So I'm going in with a toothpick around the nail to clean up the excess powder, which I probably should have done for the other two demos. Whoops. And same thing as before, I apply a layer of clear Elmer's glue. Let that dry for 5 minutes, then proceed to apply a regular top coat. And I did apply a bit too much, so I just took my nail and took the excess off. Lastly, seal the free edge of the nail, and this is what the final product looks like. I gotta say, out of all the three, my personal favorite is this one. I just love the way how it looks and how the color shifts. It's so stunning. Oh my goodness. If you haven't noticed already, I didn't do my thumb for any of these. These are what the nails look like in indoor indirect lighting. You can also layer the powder on top of any color you like, such as white, pink, purple, or blue. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!